Hi friends, I'm again here to teach you Stefan connection. So in previous lecture, we have studied the design steps of Stefan connection. अब design step पढ़ लिए है तो obviously example भी करना चाहिए क्योंकि example से ही ज्यादा समझ में आएगा. So we can understand example that how the Stefan connection is provided. Okay, so now we are going to solve one example. So the example question is this: here I have given one example. An example shows that a beam ISMB 500. What is given? So data I am writing here. Beam ISMB 500. ISMB 500 is given. Transit and end reaction of 250 kilonewton. So reaction is upon 250 kilonewton. Okay. To the flange of column of ISHB 250. So ISHB 250 column is used. Okay, at the rate 51.0 kilogram per meter means the section has its weight of 51 kilogram per meter. Design Stefan seat angle connection using 20 mm bolts means diameter of the bolt is 20 mm. Okay, and grade is 4.6. These are the data and we have to do Stefan connection. We are calculating here Stefan connection. Okay, as per I have said earlier in previous lecture that our main aim Stefan connection is done for the combined capacity, for the design of combined capacity. So what is combined capacity check? So it is on IS 800 2007 page number 76. The equation is VSB upon VDB whole square plus TB by TDB whole square. The value of this should be less than 1.0. The value of this should be less than 1.0. Okay, so we have to provide this. Now, starting with the sum, I'm rubbing this because we have not enough safe space here. Now, starting with this, अब simply भी मैं आपको मैं बताता हूँ. तो एक column है, ठीक है. एक कॉलम है, ये कॉलम की फ्लेंज है, ओके। इसके साथ हमें बीम को कनेक्ट करना है यूजिंग द स्टीफन कनेक्शन। Using the Stefan connection. So, Stefan connection के क्या parts थे? मैंने बोला था कि below में seat angle आएगा और seat angle के बाद अपना क्या आएगा? Stiffener angle आएगा, ठीक है? तो अब ये seat angle कैसे provide होगा? तो मैंने ये बोला था कि Stefan connection, in Stefan connection, the each angle will be used of equal angle section. क्या होगा? We have to use equal angle section. Both sheet angle and stiffener angle both. So step one. अब मैं ये सोचता हूँ कि अगर इक्वल एंगल ही प्रोवाइड करना है तो अपना सीट एंगल ऐसे आएगा, अवर सीट एंगल विल बी कम लाइक दिस, वी विल प्रोवाइड अवर स्टिफनर सीट एंगल लाइक दिस, दिस इज अवर सीट एंगल। तो अपना स्टेप वन क्या होगा? टू प्रोवाइड सीट एंगल। To provide a sheet angle. Okay, so in sheet, in step one will be to provide a sheet angle. Wait a 1 minute. Okay, to provide sheet angle. Now, in unstiffen connection, we have studied that how to provide the length of this angle, how to provide this dimension. The length of this is B, and this is the gap, is known as C plus T, means clearance plus tolerance. What is this? Clearance plus tolerance. Okay, means it is, we assume that 5, and this is also we assume that 5, so total it will be 10. So this is the B. B is the length of root line. B is the length of root line. So we have understand this in unstiffen connection. So by using the equation of B, length of root line, so B is equal to reaction divided by thickness of wave into Fy divided by gamma m0. This equation we have studied in unstiffen connection. If you don't know how to calculate this, then the above link will be show that how this equation works. So reaction is, we have given 250 kilonewton in the question. So reaction is equal to 250 into 10 raised to 3. And thickness of wave. Now, which thickness of wave will be considered here? Any guess? So, using the steel table, wait 1 minute. using the steel table. Now the length of root line, the reaction will be occur in the wave section of the beam. So the thickness of wave will be taken of beam. So what is our beam section? In the question, I have shown you that our beam section is ISMB 500. In the question, it is shown that our beam section is ISMB 500. So the thickness of the ISMB 500 is from the steel table is, this is steel table, we are searching for ISMB 500. So where is ISMB 500? Our ISMB 500 is here. It will come slowly moving towards the downward direction. The last one is the ISMB 500, and this is the depth, this is the width of flange, this is the thickness of flange, and this is the thickness of wave. So it is taken as 10.2. It will be taken as 10.2 into Fy is fixed 250, divide by gamma m0 means 1.10. So what will be the value of B? So the value of B will be, so the value of B will be 250 107.84. The value of B will be 107.84 mm. Okay. So this value is only from here to here, 107.84. But our angle is starting from the surface of the flange of column. Here it is sum of the gap is known as clearance plus tolerance. So the angle width will be 107.84 plus clearance and plus tolerance. So I can say that the width of angle is equal to B plus C. So it will be 107.84 plus 10. Clearance and tolerance both are mixed. So the value we will get is equal to 117.84. It means the size of our seat angle should not be less than 117.84 mm. So how we will provide the seat angle? It will be from this steel table that we have to check the dimension whose values are greater than 117.84, but kept in mind that we have to choose the equal angle section. So I am showing you how we will get the value of seat angle. So here in steel table, we have to check in equal angle section. So these are equal angle sections. See, IS 100 by 100. Here it is 100 by 100. Here is 110 by 110. And after that it comes 130 by 130. And our value is 117.84. So we have to select the section of 130 by 130. Okay, we have to select the section of 130 by 130 by 8 mm. We are selecting the 8 mm section. Okay, so as per the steel table and it is equal angle section, so provide the seat angle 130 by 130 by 8 mm. So our seat angle is like this. Indian standard angle section 130 by 130 by 8 mm. Okay, got it? Yes, how we provided the sheet angle. Okay, so step one is completed. Now moving forward to step two. Now what happened? The reaction is 250. The reaction is 250, and which will occur somewhere here. This eccentric load. It is known as, it is also known as eccentric. Somewhere here. Now, due to this reaction, a moment occurs. A moment occurs, and moment will occur here. This portion, the moment will be occur. But our seat angle is not able to take this much reaction or this much moment. So for that, we have to provide an extra supportive angle of 2 ISS like this to support this portion of the angle. So from this view, it will be seen like this. In 3D figure, I have shown you yesterday in a Stefan connection in a design step. This is the thickness of the angle. It will be placed like this. I hope you have understood yesterday. Okay, this portion is this thickness and this portion is seen here. Okay, so if we are getting balls here and balls here, then it will be shown like this here. And the minimum balls should be placed is 4. Not less than that, balls are provided. You have to place minimum 4 number of balls. If you are getting 3 numbers, then please provide 4 numbers. If you are getting 5, then it is okay. You can provide 5 balls, but not less than 4 number of balls. So like this it is placed. So it will be obviously 2 ISS because both side is the angle and both the surface is connecting by bolts. So now on which basis we provide the stiffener angle? So step 2, to provide stiffener angle. So the stiffener angle is provided on the basis of how much area is needed to resist the reaction 250 kN. So basis. Area required. So how we will calculate this? Which equation we will be used? So you have studied tension member, design of tension member. In that, the first step was TDG. It is known as yielding due to gross area. Now gross area means whatever angle we have provided, it's full area without any deduction. It is known as gross area. By using this equation, we can provide our angle like this. TDG means our reaction. Suppose TDG means our reaction, because we are studying about the tension capacity, okay, of the boat. So reaction provided will be tension. So we are using the tension equation. IS 800 page number 32. Okay. So TDG, the equation is like this. TDG is equal to AG into Fy by gamma m 0. So we have our reaction. We have Fy, we have gamma m 0. So what area will be needed to support this reaction? We will get by this equation. So putting our values like this, 250 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to AG into Fy is 250 divided by gamma m0 1.10. By this equation we will get the value of area, and the greater than that value our angle will be selected. So AG is equal to, while calculating we get the value AG is equal to 250 area 110 mm². Means the minimum area 1100 mm² is needed to resist the 250 kilonewton of reaction. So our angle which we will be provided, whose area should be greater than 1100 mm², or it might be 1100 mm², means equal to or greater than. So let me check in the steel table that which section has the area greater than 1100 mm². So in this portion also equal angle section. So here in this, it is given in the centimeter square. So let's see here, greater than 1100. So 75 by 75 by 8 is going to 11.38 centimeter square. Means it is 1138 mm², but it is very much closer to the value. So let's take it some greater value. 1400. No, in here IS 80 by 80 by 8, it is given 1220 mm². Okay, but yesterday we studied that the thickness of the stiffener angle should be greater than the thickness of the wave of the beam. So in our section IS MB 500, the thickness of the wave of the beam is 10.2. So we can provide it as a 10, or we can provide it as a 12. But what happens? The section itself will become very heavy. So if the area is resisted, or if the area is getting greater than the 1100 mm², so we can provide the minimum thickness. So let's choose the section of IS 80 by 80 by 8 of 1221 mm². Okay, so IS we will provide here stiffener angle of 2 ISA, because both side will be provided, 80 by 80 by 8 mm, whose area is greater than area 21221 mm². Okay, now we have provided this value also 80 by 80 by 8 mm. Okay, this is our section. So we have provide our stiffener angle section also. I hope you all get understand this, that how we have provided this value. Okay, let me tell you one thing also. We are going to AS100 130 by 130 and ISMB 500. Yeah. एक चीज आपको ध्यान रखनी चाहिए कि आप जब एंगल प्रोवाइड करते हैं तब कि क्यों मैंने 8 mm थिकनेस ही लिया, इसका भी एक और रीजन है। देखो मैं बताता हूँ, ये कहीं पे दिया नहीं होगा आपको, पर ये प्रैक्टिकली आपको सोचना पड़ता है कि क्यों ऐसा करना होता है। सपोज आप ये समझ लो, देखो मैं दो व्यू में आपको फिगर दिखाऊंगा, एक 2D और एक 3D। अब मेरा ये सीट एंगल है, क्या है मेरा ये सीट एंगल है, ऐसे प्लेस किया हुआ है। ठीक है, अगर सामने से मैं उसे देखूंगा तो ये ऐसा दिखेगा, ठीक है। ये इसकी थिकनेस यहाँ की है वो ये रही, और इसका फ्रंट व्यू यहाँ पे, ठीक है ऐसा दिखेगा। अब यहाँ पे क्या होगा कि मैं ये स्टिफनर एंगल प्रोवाइड करता हूँ ऐसे, और दूसरा स्टिफनर एंगल होगा पीछे, ऐसे, ठीक है ऐसे समझ लो। तो सामने कैसा दिखेगा, ऐसा दिखेगा, ये इसकी थिकनेस, ये इसकी थिकनेस, और यूं और यूं, ठीक है। तो अब मैंने क्या प्रोवाइड किया, 80 mm by 80 mm by 8 mm का प्रोवाइड किया। क्यों ऐसा प्रोवाइड किया, तो यहां पे देखो अपने ये एंगल की जो लेंथ है वो कितनी होनी चाहिए, अपने एंगल की साइज तो मिल गई। एंगल की साइज क्या थी अपनी, ये वाली देखो, ये थी 130, इसकी डेप्थ भी थी 130 और इसकी थिकनेस थी 8 mm, और इसका मैंने क्या किया, ये 80, ये 80 थिकनेस, 8 + 8 मीन 16, और ये 80, और यहाँ पे भी 80 हो जाएगा इसका, ऐसे बाहर आएगा, ठीक है। तो यहाँ की टोटल लेंथ क्या हो गई, तो 80 प्लस बीच का ये 16 प्लस वापिस ये 80, तो कितनी हो गई, 80 प्लस 80 हो गई, 160 प्लस 16 मतलब 176 mm हो गई। और ये अपना सीट एंगल की लेंथ किसके हिसाब से डिसाइड होती है, कि विड्थ ऑफ फ्लेंज ऑफ बीम। तो अपन कौन सा एंगल सेक्शन यूज, बीम सेक्शन यूज कर रहे हैं, ISMB 500। तो इसकी विड्थ ऑफ बीम कितनी है, ये रे 180 है, ये नीचे आपको दिख रही है 180, तो ये 180 है, ठीक है। तो अपनी दोनों एंगल की लेंथ मिलके 180 से कम होनी चाहिए, क्या होनी चाहिए, ये जो 180 है ना, तो अपना दोनों एंगल मिक्स होके टोटल लेंथ इसकी 180 से कम होनी चाहिए। क्यों 180 से कम होनी चाहिए, अगर 180 से ज्यादा, अगर मैं यहाँ पे थिकनेस ऑफ वेब के हिसाब से अगर थिकनेस और वेब से ज्यादा थिकनेस सिलेक्ट करता है एंगल की, तो यहाँ पे क्या हो जाता 12 12 तो ये 24 और 80 प्लस 80 तो कितना 160 प्लस 24 मींस 1884 हो जाती, जो इससे ज्यादा हो जाती तो अपना एंगल ऐसे दिखता। एक्सटीरियर लुक क्या कैसा दिखता, ऐसे दिखता, ये थोड़ा बाहर आ जाता। सो एज ए स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियर वी ऑल्सो नीड टू सी द एक्सटीरियर लुक ऑल्सो, बिकॉज इफ यू कम आउटसाइड द कॉलम और आउटसाइड द बीम दैट इज नॉट अप्रोप्रिएट, सो वी नीड टू मैनेज द लेंथ ऑफ बोथ एंगल of the mix-up of both angle should be less than the width of flange of the beam. So, हमारे दोनों angle मिल के total जो length बनाते हैं यहाँ की नीचे की अपनी, वो ये beam से width of flange of beam से कम होनी चाहिए, और यहाँ पे अपनी 176 जो 180 से कम हो रही है, so it is okay. तो ये ध्यान में रखते हुए अपन को यहाँ के एंगल की थिकनेस डिसाइड करनी होती है। ओके, तो आई होप यू गॉट इट ऑल। नाउ वी हैव प्रोवाइडेड सीट एंगल एंड स्टिफनर एंगल, सो लेट मी रिमेम्बर यू वंस अगेन दैट व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव। ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ आवर इज दैट we have to check VSB by VDB whole square plus TB by TDB whole square should be less than or equal to 1.0. We have to check this equation. Okay, in that VSB is depend on the number of bolts. VSB kis pe depend hai? नंबर ऑफ बोल्स पे डिपेंड है। तो लेट्स सॉल्व स्टेप थ्री, नंबर ऑफ बोल्स। स्टेप थ्री इज नंबर ऑफ बोल्स। द इक्वेशन ऑफ नंबर ऑफ बोल्स इन लास्ट लेक्चर आई हैव मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट एन इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ and I write it some 6M by M into P into VDB. Okay, what 6 into M into small m into P into VDB. Okay, the small m is fixed value, two number. Okay, and P is the pitch distance. What is P? P is the pitch distance is equal to 2.5 into D. So what is the value of 2.5 or 2.5 into D? Diameter we have given 20 mm in the question. So it will be 50 mm. Okay. So the value of P will be 50. Okay. Now what is the value of VDB? So in unstiffened connection also I have make you understand, and in the first lecture of cleat angle connection I have shown you one table that for 16 mm it is 29 for single shear and for double shear it is 58. What will be the value of here? It will be single shear because the bolts will be connected here, and here despite of choosing two ISA angle like this, the shearing effect will be on one side only, not double side. The plane, the single plane will be take the shearing effect, not the double plane. A plane will take single side, not back side. So single side, it will be single shear. So it will be single shear. And for single shear, if the diameter of bolt is 20, then the VDB value will be 45.3. for 20 mm diameter. So this value is 45.3 into 10 raised to 3 in Newton we have to write. Now moment. So how we will calculate the moment? So So here somewhere the reaction is occurring. So in last lecture I have make you understand the moment will be at the reaction will be at in the center portion of the seat angle. So our seat angle is like this. This is 130 and this is also 130. So our reaction is occurring here and we are taking the center portion. The 130 by 2 is equal to 65. Okay, 130 by 2. Eccentricity distance is equal to total width divided by 2 is equal to 65 mm. And the definition of moment, so m is equal to what? Reaction into eccentric distance, force into distance. So what is the reaction? Reaction is 250 and eccentric distance is equal to 65. So what will be the value? Into 10 raised to 3 into 65. So the moment will be 16.25 into 10 raised to 6 Newton into mm. I hope you all understand. So putting all the value in the equation, we will get the number of bulls. So by putting all the value in the equation, so under root of 6 into 16.25 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 2 into 50 into 45.3 into 10 raised to 3. The number of bolts will be 6 into 16.25 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 2 into 50 into 45.3 into 10 raised to 3. Under root of answer, the number of bolts is 4.63. So we can take it 5 numbers. These should not be less than 4 numbers. Minimum we have to provide 4 numbers of bolts. Okay, so we are getting the number of bolts as 5. So we can place here 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and here it will be joined like this 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, here the packing will be provided. Okay, so we get the number of bolts as 5 numbers of bolts in stiffener angle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so we get the number of bolts. I hope you have understand all the things. Now, the next step is, so on this, after this calculation, we get two values. 5 numbers and VDB. VDB is 45.3. We get the value of VDB. Okay. Now we also, we will get the value of VSB. So VSB is equal to what? It is the value of shear capacity per bolt. Shear capacity per bolt. The per bolt means we have 5 number of bolts here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 5 bolts here, 5 bolts here and 5 bolts back side. So we have the number of, total number of bolts is equal to 2 into 5 because we are placing it both sides. So 10 numbers. So each bolt will take reaction is equal to VSB is equal to shear capacity per bolt reaction divided by number of bolts. So reaction is 250 divided by number of bolts 10. It means 25 kilonewton. It means each volts will take 25. So this value is also I have got 25. Okay, so two values we have get 25 VSB and 45.3 VDB. Now we need to find these two values, and after that we can check whether it is less than 1 or not. So moving forward to TB, value of TB. And in previous lecture I have explained you that what is the equation of TB. So step 4, value of TB, it is the tension capacity per volt. So TB is equal to equation, it is M dash into YN divided by summation of Y square. These three values are unknown for us. So for calculating TB, we need to find M dash, YN and summation of Y square firstly. So what is the equation of M dash? So M dash is equal to M upon 1 plus 2H by 21 into summation of Y by summation of Y square. 2H by 21 into summation of Y plus summation of into summation of Y square. So what is the value of summation of Y? How we will find it? So see, in previous lecture I haven't understand you what is the value of summation of Y. These all values 1, 2, 3, 4, it depends on number of volts. This value we have get 16.25 to 10 raised to 6. So how we will find it? So this, I am showing you this portion like this. One, two, three, four, and five. The total length will be, each edge distance is 40, pitch is 50, 50, 50, 50, and 40. Total distance is 280 mm. Okay, 5 into 4, 200. 240 and 280. So the H is the distance from the top bolt, center of top bolt to the bottom. So it is 280 minus 40. H is equal to 240 mm. This is the value of small h. So we have get the value of small h, 240 mm. Now what is YN? YN is equal to H minus H by 7, critical axis that we draw here. Like this, diagram will become like this. This is our critical axis. So the value of critical axis is H by 7. H is 240 and value of critical axis is H by 7. So what is the H by 7? H by 7 means 240 by 7. Then it will be 34.28. Is 34.28. This is the critical axis. Okay. So minus 34.28. The first bolt will break here. So जैसे कि ऐसे अपन ने सपोर्ट किया हुआ है, ठीक है, तो सबसे ज्यादा कहाँ पे इफेक्ट होगी? ऐसे ऐसे इफेक्ट होगी, ऐसे, तो ये पहले ब्रेक हो जाएगा, ठीक है, तो ये क्रिटिकल एक्सिस यहाँ पे, ओके। तो क्रिटिकल एक्सिस कितने डिस्टेंस पे है? बॉटम से 34.28 डिस्टेंस पे है। तो अवर वाई एन वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू 240 माइनस 34.28, तो 205.72। दिस इज ऑलवेज फिक्स्ड डिवाइड बाय 7, ओके। सो वी गॉट टू वैल्यूज, विच वैल्यूज वी हैव गॉट? एच इज इक्वल टू 240 mm, देन वाई एन इज इक्वल टू 205.72, एंड वी गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ क्रिटिकल एक्सिस ऑल्सो। सो वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ समेशन ऑफ वाई? तो समेशन ऑफ वाई मीन्स टू माइनस इच डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम क्रिटिकल एक्सिस पर्टिक्युलरली। सो लेट्स सी, फर्स्ट 40, इच बोल्ट डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द बॉटम माइनस क्रिटिकल एक्सिस, हर एक बोल्ट का डिस्टेंस क्रिटिकल एक्सिस से माइनस करना है बॉटम से, ठीक है। तो यहां से पहले बोल्ट का डिस्टेंस क्या है? 40 mm है, 40 माइनस 34.28, ठीक है। अब समेशन है तो क्या होगा? प्लस ही होगा, समेशन है तो सबका प्लस ही होगा, सो प्लस। दूसरा डिस्टेंस, दूसरे बोर्ड का डिस्टेंस क्या है? 40 प्लस 50 90, सो 90 माइनस 34.28। तीसरे बोर्ड का डिस्टेंस क्या है? 90 प्लस 50 मीन्स 140 माइनस 34.28। फोर्थ बोर्ड का डिस्टेंस क्या है? 40 50 90 90 50 140 140 190, तो क्या होगा? प्लस 190 माइनस 34.28। लास्ट बोल्ट का डिस्टेंस क्या है? 240, सो प्लस 240 माइनस 34.28। सो ये दोनों साइड होगा, इसलिए इसको मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2 करना है। क्या करना है? मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2, बिकॉज ये सिंगल साइड हुआ वैसा दूसरी साइड भी होगा। तो ये जो आप सॉल्व करोगे तो अपनी वैल्यू आएगी क्या? समेशन ऑफ वाई की वैल्यू आ जाएगी। समेशन ऑफ वाई की वैल्यू क्या आती है? तो लेट्स सॉल्व इट। तो 40 माइनस 34.28 प्लस 90 माइनस 34.28 प्लस 140 माइनस 34.28 प्लस 240 माइनस 34.28 इंटू 2, तो कितनी आई? 1057.2 आई, 1057.2 mm, ओके। तो ये समेशन ऑफ वाई की वैल्यू अपन को मिल गई, क्या मिली? 1057.2। अब समेशन ऑफ वाई स्क्वायर की वैल्यू क्या होगी? तो ये सब स्टेप्स को पर्टिकुलरली स्क्वायर कर दो, तो आपको मिल जाएगी समेशन ऑफ वाई स्क्वायर की वैल्यू, मीन्स 40 माइनस 34.28 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 90 माइनस 34.28 होल स्क्वायर स्क्वायर प्लस 90 माइनस, तो पर्टिकुलरली सबको अप कर दो तो ये क्या हो गया? 5.72। अगर मैं माइनस करो तो 90 माइनस 34.28, तो ये क्या हो गया? 55.72। ये हो गया 105.72, ये हो गया 155.72, और ये होगा 205.72। तो ये सारी वैल्यू को स्क्वायर करके आप समेशन कर दो, 5.72 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 55.72 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 105.72 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 155.72 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 205.72 होल स्क्वायर, इनटू टू, क्योंकि ये भी दोनों साइड ही होगा, तो समेशन ऑफ वाई स्क्वायर की वैल्यू क्या आ गई 161767.184। तो समेशन ऑफ वाई स्क्वायर की वैल्यू भी अपन को मिल गई, क्या मिल गई 161767.184, ठीक है। तो ये सारी वैल्यू अपन को मिल गई। अब अपन को क्या करना है, सिर्फ इसको इक्वेशन में पुट करना है। तो कैसे रखेंगे, देखो अब फाइंड क्या करना है टीबी। तो टीबी का क्या था इक्वेशन, टीबी का इक्वेशन था एम डैश वाई एन अपन समेशन ऑफ वाई स्क्वायर। यहाँ पे हमारे पास दो वैल्यू है वाई एन और समेशन ऑफ वाई स्क्वायर, बस एम डैश फाइंड करना है। एम डैश का इक्वेशन क्या था कि एम डिवाइड बाय 1+2 इंटू एच बाय 21 इंटू समेशन ऑफ वाई बाय समेशन ऑफ वाई स्क्वायर। सो वॉट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ एम डैश, we know the value of f is equal to 16.25 into 6। so pehle hum niche ka solve kar dete hain, jaise ki m ki value apan ko pata hai 16.25 into 6 divide by 1+2h, h ki value kya hai 240, 2 into 240 divide by 21 into summation of y ki value kya hai 1057.2 aur y square ki value kya hai 161767.18। तो ये सॉल्व करते हैं 1057.2 डिवाइड बाय 161767.18 इनटू 480 डिवाइड बाय 21। याद रखो कि ये पीछे के स्टेप की वैल्यू जो प्लस के बाद की है ना, वो हमेशा वन से कम ही आएगी, क्योंकि ये नीचे का आंसर कभी भी माइनस में नहीं आना चाहिए। तो अपना है 0.149, तो 1.149, तो 16.25 टू 10 रेस टू 6 डिवाइड बाय आंसर। सो इट एम डैश वैल्यू इज 14.14 इंटू 10 रेस टू 6 न्यूटन इंटू mm। ओके, तो अपन को ये मिल गए, तो यहाँ पे रखते हैं 14.14 इंटू 10 रेस टू 6 इंटू वाई एन की वैल्यू क्या है 205.72 डिवाइड बाय समेशन ऑफ वाई स्क्वायर मीन्स 161767.18। नाउ सॉल्विंग दिस वी विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ टीबी। टीबी इज वन टाइप ऑफ फोर्स, मीन्स इट विल बी गेट इन किलो न्यूटन। सो 14.14 इंटू 10 रेस टू 6 इंटू 205.72 डिवाइड बाई 161767.18। तो द वैल्यू इज 17.98 किलो न्यूटन, 17.98 किलो न्यूटन। तो द वैल्यू ऑफ टीबी इज 17.98 किलो न्यूटन। नाउ द लास्ट वैल्यू द टीबी इक्वेशन we have to find is lengthy sum hai par difficult nahi hai, it is easy, you will if you practice it once and twice you will get all the difficulty solved in your mind regarding to the equations. So the equation of TDB is on page number 76 and the equation is, what is the equation? So the equation is, let me show you in the IS 800. Page number 76. FYB ASB by gamma MB, yeah, gamma M0. It is the equation FYB into ASB by gamma m 0. What is the equation? FYB. So I have explained you in the last lecture what is the value of FYB for 4.6 grade. The value of FYB is 240 Newton per mm square. And ASB is the nothing but the sank area is equal to pi by 4 d square. So ASB is equal to pi by 4 into d square is the diameter of bolt. So 20 mm diameter is there. So what is the equation? What is the area? Pi by 4 into d square, 3.14 into 20. 314 mm square. So we get the value of 314. And gamma m0 is nothing but the 1.10. So the value of TdB is 68.5. What is the value of TdB is 68.5 kilonewton. This value is 90% will be same, 68.5. Why? Because if we use 4.6 grade, the 240 is fixed value. If we use 20 mm diameter, the 314 is fixed value and 1.10 is fixed value. Then this will be, if you have given 4.6 and 20 mm dia, then you directly write it 68.5. Okay, so now the all four value we have get. Now let's check it that our angle, provided angle, is it okay or not. So for that, the last step for checking is the combined capacity. VSB by VDB whole square plus TB by TDB whole square should be less than or equal to 1.0. Okay, let me check. Coming or not. So, the value of VSB is what? 25. The value of VDB is 45.3 whole square plus TB is 17.98 and TDB is 68.5. Let's check. So 25 by 45.3 whole square is equal to 0.30. plus 17.98 divided by 68.5 whole square is equal to 0.06, which will get 0.36, and it is less than 1.0. So it is okay. So our section provided can resist 250 kilonewton. I hope you all get it, and I hope you all understand that how to calculate Stefan connection. So for today, that's it. In next lecture, we come with other topic. So bye-bye. Take care.